Hello. Welcome back to Architutors. In this video we will show you how to render a plan in AutoCAD and make your own hatching standard or pattern in AutoCAD. We'll be trying to replicate the hatch patterns used in Ultratech's Utec in their drawings. So let's see how it can be done. As you see, we have a very basic house plan here made in AutoCAD, with provision of different spaces. Furniture is already set. Make sure you have created a separate layer for hatching. Like in this drawing, we're using a layer called floor hatch. You can turn off unnecessary layers like the text layer. First, let's start with hatch for bedroom. One way to do is to create a boundary like a rectangle that we can later select and hatch. We can basically use rectangles for rectangular spaces. Now that we have created a boundary for this bedroom, let's go to the hatch command and click on select boundary objects and select the rectangular boundaries we created, and hit enter. It'll pick a default hatch at first that we are going to change. We'll be changing its color in the hatch pattern. First, I'm going to select the hatch and change its color. I'll select a true color. Now we can either choose by gradient or by filling in specific RGB values of a color. Make sure you subscribe to our channel to tune into all upcoming architectural tutorials. Just add in these values and click OK. Now let's also change the pattern of the hatch. After selecting the pattern, we can change its angle of rotation and the scale. Now let's do a second hatch underneath this pattern hatch. Second hatch will be a fill of a specific complementary color. Similar to previous, select the rectangles for the hatch, I'll select solid hatch and then fill in values for a true color. When this is done, we can push this hatch underneath the pattern by using draw order command and send it to back. Both hatches should be underneath the furniture objects. And at last, remove those rectangles we drew for the boundary of the hatch. That's our bedroom hatch. Now let's work the kitchen. First, draw a rectangle for the area of the kitchen. For kitchen, we'll only do a pattern hatch and not a solid hatch. Define a RGB color for the hatch. And adjust scale and angle of this hatch. Now for the bathroom and toilet hatch, draw rectangles for necessary area. We'll only do a pattern hatch for this also and not a solid hatch. And adjust scale and angle of this hatch. Erase the rectangles we had created. Now let's create hatch for the living areas and heat passages. It's going to have a double hatch. One pattern and one solid hatch. Draw rectangles to define the area of the hatch. First, I'll be doing a solid hatch. Define RGB values and hit OK. It's going to have a beige color. Once that is done, we'll do a pattern hatch over it that will be similar to the kitchen hatch. And change the draw order of the hatches. Now before we go any further, let's see the plan in preview of how it looks. Using the plot command, select the area from the window of the plan and click on preview. Now let's hatch the walls. It'll be having a black color hatch. To do that, first isolate the walls by layer isolate command and selecting the wall layer. Go to the hatch command and do any default hatch pattern first. Now change it to solid pattern and define the black color. Let's see it in preview. We're still left to do the hatching for the part outside the plot. Let's start with the parking area. Define the boundary using rectangle for parking area and do a pattern hatch. Select pattern. Adjust the scale and rotation of the pattern. Define RGB values of true color. Next, also give it a solid hatch. Faux that make the selection and define true color for solid hatch. Change the draw order of the hatches. After this, we'll do hatch for the landscape by first making the rectangular boundary. We can select grass pattern for the hatch. Edit the scale of it and also apply a true color to it. Follow it by giving a solid green hatch underneath. Let's also make a hatch for the steps and the landing. First a pattern followed by the true color. And then following it by adding a solid color hatch to it. Change the draw order so all hatches are visible. Apply the used hatches to other elements. I'll use the hatch for the partition walls as well. We're almost there. Now let's also give a transparent gray hatch to the offsets around the plot. First make proper rectangles. Hatch them using solid hatch. And give it a gray color hatch. I'll add transparency to it by 70%. We can erase those rectangular boundaries. Turn all layers on. And let's check how it looks. Enter plot command and make sure to turn on plot transparency option. Let's change the draw order of wall hatch and make it come to the top. This is how you can go about making your own hatch preset for rendering floor plans in AutoCAD. We have followed a preset similar to Utec, but you can do your own experiments on what looks best. Anna, make sure to subscribe to our channel and turn notifications on to follow all our upcoming tutorials on architecture, design, rendering and post-production. Thank you. See you next time.